Hi guys, I'm Glenn from URender, and in this video I will show you how you can use our subsurface scattering to create realistic skin materials. Subsurface scattering tends to soften the overall effect of lighting and scatters the light within the material itself. You can try it out yourself and hold your hand against the sun. You will notice how the edges of your fingers turn red because the light enters your skin. I prepared the 3D scene in lighting. I've got this head model here, and I already uploaded the textures for the color, reflectance, emissive and the normal channel. Make sure that your lights have shadows enabled for subsurface scattering to work. You can decide between soft and hard shadows in your light tech under shadow mode. Now head over to the material. The surface scattering smooths everything out and defines how much light is scattered within the material. And the translucency defines how much light reaches the front. I usually start with the translucency first and smooth everything out with the surface scattering. So let me turn off the surface scattering for now. I will decrease the strength and increase the wrap lighting to 1. Now enable subsurface scattering, change the color to a red light. Bring down the strength and increase the depth falloff to 5. If you like to have a more textured look for the skin, you can either increase the sample distribution or use a slightly darker red for the subsurface color. You can also adjust the subsurface light scale of every light in the shadow tab. Just click on the URender light tag you want to adjust, go to Attributes, Shadow, and over here under subsurface, you can adjust the light scale. Here again, a comparison of the skin with subsurface scattering turned on and off. And a different example. For more information, check out our SSS overview tutorial if you haven't done already. So guys, that's it for this video. Hope you liked it and see you next time. And of course, have fun with URender.